I've been working alongside our contractors all summer to complete our backyard renovation, and the project is nearly complete. We've added a fence, installed a retaining wall, built a deck, installed a shipping container pool, and added a pergola. And my husband and I are thrilled with how it's come out, right, Dan?
Yeah, absolutely. The new space looks great. The kids are really enjoying the backyard. I mean, honestly, I think we just need some seating so we can watch the kids swim in the pool.
So I think I have an idea for that, and I was wondering if you'd help me in the shop today.
Yeah, I kind of figured I'd have something up your sleeve.
All right, let's head to the shop.
All right. Oh, I see you have some of our extra deck boards here.
Yeah, so these are made out of a composite material and they're virtually maintenance-free, so I thought they would be the perfect solution for these chairs that we're gonna build. Once we build the frame, it's gonna be a really sturdy chair since they're so heavy and strong. And also, they're going to not need any paint or stain, which is gonna make this project go much quicker.
Sounds awesome. What kind of chair are you looking to build?
So I picked up these cushions that are lounge chair cushions, and I thought they would be perfect for a long base and then an adjustable backrest if you want to sit up or lay down.
All right, let's get started.
All right, so the first step in this process is to make the deck boards not look like deck boards.
Okay.
And to do that, we're going to be ripping off one edge of our frame pieces so that this ends up being 4 inches wide and has a nice finished edge for the top of our chair. Now we can apply stain to this too so that it matches the face color. And then for our legs, we're actually gonna rip off both sides, and that'll give us a more finished look for the legs of the chair. So we can set our table saw up for 4 inches once we raise it up and make some cuts. So now we're gonna use the miter saw to cut our legs to length. So the way we cut the angles on these is so that I have a pair and you have a pair. And so if you stand these up, when we sandwich each leg together, it's gonna give it strength and also gonna provide a shoulder for the frame of the chair to sit on. And then we'll be able to screw through here into the frame, which will keep it from wobbling as well. So we need to screw these together.
Okay.
First, we will dampen this and then glue. Clamp on that. If you'll line that up, I'll clamp.
Yep.
We're always going to pre-drill, and then we're also going to drill an additional larger hole for the head of the screw so that it doesn't sort of mushroom up the finish on the top of this board. And then we're using screws that are specially meant for composite wood that'll help with drilling into wood like this a lot. And then we can't fill it with wood filler, so we're gonna be using these specialty plugs which match our finish, and we'll be tapping these in to cover the screw holes so they're not so obvious.
So now that our legs are cut and assembled, we just need to begin to assemble the frame, correct?
Yep, so the first thing that we'll do is we'll place the legs on the inside wall of the frame. Now, once we're done attaching the legs, we're gonna use the cutoff from the board that we ripped as a rail for our seat slats to sit on. But then when we get to the top of the chair, we need our backrest to rotate. So I slimmed the leg slightly shorter so that we can have a rotating backrest. All right, so now that we have the legs attached to the sides of the frame, we can attach the ends and bring the whole thing together. All right, so we're gonna flip this over, and then before we install the slats, we'll start supporting the backrest. So the first thing that I need to do is support these because they're independent of each other. I'll put one more piece between them, and then at the bottom, I'll add a stop block to further support the backrest when it's in the down position. But while I do this, you could start installing the slats.
All right, sounds good.
Starting at the bottom of the seat and top of the backrest, we're using a 1-inch thick scrap block to create even gaps between the slats. Where the seat and backrest meet in the middle, a slightly larger gap is left over, which is needed to allow the backrest to adjust to different positions. All right, so this simple swing arm, which is just three boards in a U shape, we've bolted it to the inside of the backrest, and we can now rest it on the shelf that I've installed between the legs, or we can set it upright and lower this down. And now this is a completely flat lounge chair if you wanted to lay down and take a nap.
Awesome, I love it. All right.
That looks great.
You know, I think out of all the projects we've done so far, this has by far been my favorite.
Yeah, well, at least it lets us relax a little, right?
I guess so, right? Nice job, though.
And enjoy the backyard renovation and finally be done.
Yep.
Thanks for watching. This Old House has got a video for just about every home improvement project, so be sure to check out the others. And if you like what you see, click on the subscribe button to make sure that you get our newest videos right in your feed.